Hello students, welcome to the video lecture series of class 12th business studies. Today we are going to continue with the staffing chapter. We have already discussed the meaning, importance and the steps of staffing function in our earlier lecture. Now we are going to discuss in detail the recruitment step of staffing function. The topics which are covered in this video are meaning of recruitment, sources of recruitment, and third is comparison of different sources of recruitment, that is comparison between internal sources and external sources. Students, you already know that recruitment is defined as a process of searching for prospective employees and stimulating them to apply for the jobs in the organization. And the main objective of recruitment is to create a pool of prospective candidates with necessary characteristics or qualifications. The two sources of recruitment are, first is internal sources. Under internal sources, we have two subparts. First is transfer and second is promotion. The another one is external sources. Now, what is transfer? Transfer is shifting of employee from one job to another, from one department to another, or from one shift to another. In transfer, there is no change in the responsibility or the status of employee. This type of shifting of employee is called as horizontal shifting. Benefit of transfer in the organization is it helps in shifting the employees from an overstaffed department to an understaffed department. And in some cases, it also helps in avoiding termination and removing the individual problems and the grievances which are there. Next is promotion. It also comes under the internal source of recruitment. Promotion is shifting employee from a lower job position to a higher job position. And with this, employee will be having more responsibilities, more pay and more status. And this type of shifting is called as vertical shifting of employees. The benefit which promotion offers is it improves the motivation, loyalty and the satisfaction level of the employee. And if there is one promotion at a higher level, it will lead to chain of promotion at lower level in the organization. So we have discussed two sources under the category internal. Now, external sources of recruitment are first, direct recruitment, second, casual callers, third, advertisements, fourth, employment exchange, fifth, placement agencies and management consultants, sixth, campus recruitment, seventh, recommendation of employees, eighth, labor contractors, ninth, advertisement on television, and last is web publishing. Now we are going to do in detail what are these external sources of recruitment. First, we are going to start with direct recruitment. Under this method, a notice is placed on the notice board of an enterprise specifying details of the job available. The job seekers, they assemble outside the premises of the organization on the date which is specified in the notice. And superior or a head comes on the spot, and on the spot the selection is done. Second method is casual callers. Many reputed business organizations keep a data of unsolicited applications in their offices. Now, what do you mean by unsolicited application is there are some people or applicants who give their CVs or biodatas in the organization, although there is no post advertised. So organization keep all those CVs and biodatas with them, and list of such job seekers can be prepared and can be screened to fill the vacancies when they arise in the organization. Next is advertisements. Advertisements is a very popular way in which recruitment is done. Under advertisement, the situation, vacant advertisement is put in a newspaper or a professional journal. The benefit of this type of source of recruitment is more information about the organization and the job can be given in the advertisement, and advertisement gives management a wider range of candidates from which they can choose the best candidate. Next is employment exchange. Employment exchange, they are set up by Government of India. They are the good source of recruitment for unskilled and skilled operative jobs. Next is placement agencies and management consultants. Placement agencies are the private agencies or a professional bodies, and they compile a biodata of different types of people, and they charge a fee for their service. And as and when there is a requirement in the organization, they contact the placement agencies and they provide them with the required person with the required qualification. Similarly, management consultants, they are specializing in middle level and top level executive placements. They maintain a database of person with different qualification and skills, and even advertise jobs on behalf of their clients. Next is campus recruitment. As you all know that a lot of engineering colleges, management colleges and vocational schools, they have the companies coming up for placement. So campus recruitment is when business houses, they are approaching universities, colleges, management institute to recruit people for their organization. It is a popular source of recruitment for technical, professional and managerial jobs. Next is recommendation of present employees. So there are employees who are already working in the organization. They may recommend their friend, their relative or their known one so that they can work in that organization. And what is the benefit of this particular source of recruitment is background of the employee is sufficiently known and supported by present employees. There are less chances that we are not going to get a good employee because the people who are already working in the organization, they are going to recommend a person whom they actually know. Next is labor contractor. All the business firms, they maintain a close contact with the labor contractors. And labor contractors, they have a link with laborers. So as and when there is a requirement of labor in business due to shortage, or when the permanent labor are not there, or when they have gone to their villages, at that time, business contact the labor contractor, and labor contractor provide the required number of labor to the organization. Next is advertisement on television. So you have seen the advertisement on television about situation vacant. Under this type of source of recruitment, details of the job of the organization, they are advertised or telecasted on the television, and profile of the organization and a vacancy which exists in the organization, all the details, they are there on the television screen, and the prospective job applicants can see that advertisement and they can apply for the jobs in the organization. Next is web publishing. Websites are specially designed for providing information to both job seekers as well as the job openings. They are commonly visited by both prospective employees and the organization who are there in search of a suitable candidates. Now we are going to compare these two sources. We have done internal sources and external sources. Under internal sources, you have seen there are two things. First is transfer, second is promotion. And under external sources, you have seen web publishing, advertisement on television, campus recruitment. So there are various external sources. So now let us compare internal sources and external sources. So you can see this table. The first basis on which we are going to compare is choice. Under internal source of recruitment, choice is limited. Whereas if firm is using external source of recruitment, the choice is wider. The second basis is fresh talent. In which particular source of recruitment there are chances of getting fresh talent is external source. In internal source of recruitment, you are getting the same people who are already working in the organization. So if you want fresh talent in your organization, people with new thinking, new blood in the organization, external source of recruitment would be more preferable. The third basis is competitive spirit. Now, if firm is only relying on internal source of recruitment, the spirit of competition among existing employee, it decreases. But if firm is using internal as well as external sources, in such a case, internal employees know that they have to compete with outsiders. So the spirit of competition is very high. They will try to prove themselves that they are better than the outsiders. So spirit of competition will be very high if you're using external source of recruitment. Next basis is cost and the time involved. If we compare internal sources as well as external sources, the time and the cost involved in external sources is more, because you need to advertise, you need to go for the selection of employees, you need to go for other formalities which are there. But in case of internal sources, employees are already working in your organization, you know them, so there is less time and cost involved when you're using internal sources, but external source turns out to be costly and time consuming. Next is qualified personnel. When you compare internal and external sources, there are more chances that we get people with more or better qualification in external sources. Whereas in internal sources, we have to compromise with the people who are already there in the organization with the required qualification. So if you want people which are more qualified, then the type of recruitment which firm should use is external source of recruitment. Next basis is, what is the effect on existing staff? If a firm only uses internal source, it motivates the employee. They know that they'll be promoted. Whenever there is a job opening in the organization, they will be promoted. So it motivates the employees who are already there in the organization. Whereas if firm uses external sources, it actually demotivates the employee. They feel that they have less chance. Some person from outside will be appointed and they will not get the promotion. So it demotivates the employee. So you have seen that both internal and external sources of recruitment, there are certain advantages and certain disadvantages. So organization, they have to see, they have to weigh the advantages and the disadvantages, and they have to find out which source of recruitment they are going to use for their organization. Students, in this lecture we have done what is recruitment, what are the various sources of recruitment, and we have also done the comparison of internal sources as well as external sources, and this comparison has given you a clear view of what are the advantages and disadvantages of internal sources of recruitment as well as external sources of recruitment. In our next lecture, we are going to discuss what are the steps of selection, what are the different training methods, and staffing as a part of HRM. HRM means human resource management.